Welcome back to Fossil Ridge Games. Today, I'm going to walk you through a strategy guide for how to play the game Anvil. Anvil is a top-down shooter that has elements from many classic games, such as Helldivers, Diablo. There's also sort of a flair when it comes to character design. A lot of the characters are reminiscent of the game Overwatch and Heroes of the Storm / Dota. So if you're into any of those games, you're going to see a lot of these common elements found in this game as well. This is a multiplayer game where you can play anywhere from 1 to 4 different breakers. A breaker is essentially a mechanized battle suit, and each mechanized battle suit has a host of different skills and abilities that you can power up over the course of the game. There are different weapons, there are different skills, and there are different relics that you can equip on your breaker throughout the course of the game. Now, when you play this game, it's a one-time shot. So think of it as once you load up a character, you level up that character with different relics and weapons and skills over the course of the game. But once that breaker is defeated, or if you win the galaxy that you're playing, you have to start over every time. So that's where those elements kind of that you see from Dota and Heroes of the Storm come in. It's kind of like a game that you play from anywhere from maybe 30 minutes to an hour, depending on how many different missions and planets that you run through, and then your character resets. So those elements of the game are pretty consistent with both Heroes of the Storm / Dota. When you start the game Anvil, you will have access to 3 different breakers. The first one is Jungler, which is located in the upper left corner of the screen. Next, you have Guillotine, and Guillotine is going to be like a hand-to-hand melee character. And then finally, you have access to Elsa. Something else that you are going to notice in the top right portion of the screen, there's this blue icon, and those are called Krons. Krons can be obtained by going through the different missions and essentially winning those missions, and you're going to get points from winning or losing those missions. And if you obviously win the mission, you're going to get more points. But if you lose the mission and you play for a while, you're still going to get points. This will allow you to get these Krons as you level up. So, you know, different levels give you different things. Some of the levels give you Krons. Some of the levels give you these season points, which are located just to the right. And this is going to be how you sort of upgrade your account for this game. In addition, you can win skins also as you level up your character. So the first important thing to note is that this game really kind of revolves around upgrading your entire account and thus all of your characters within that account. So as an example, if you want to purchase another one of these breakers, it's going to cost you about 1,000 of the Krons to do that. Now, something else that you can do is you can go over to the upgrade section, which is just located across the sort of entry lobby. These are going to be your system upgrades, and these are going to occur in the season that you're playing. Currently, the game is in preseason. So as you can see, you can use your season points to upgrade these different levels. So as an example, we have the health sort of icon 1 located right here. And that's going to give you increased maximum hit points. And this is going to be for all of your breakers. So you can progress down these trees and really kind of look at different and additional skills as you go up. There are minimums that you need to move on to the next level. So as an example, this gain shield 1, we need to have 5 points to do this upgrade for that skill. Now, once again, this is going to apply to all of your breakers, and you can choose between offensive, defensive, and strategic. So this is kind of a deep way to customize your account for the game, which I think is really, really cool, really, really exciting. This is the season window, and when you play through a mission, you are going to receive essentially like victory points. And once you get enough victory points, you're going to level up. So as an example, you know, we're at level 27 right now, and once we complete level 27, we move to level 28, and it will unlock this different sort of customized gear. And if we hit level 29, then we're going to win the 300 Krons, and then once we hit level 30, we're going to get those 3 season points. So these are the ways that you're going to upgrade your account. So you're going to use the Krons to purchase some of the toy workers. You're going to use the Krons to also purchase new and different breakers. Obviously, then you can win the skins as well. And then finally, these season points are going to be used to unlock that season tree that I showed you previously. You can go all the way to level 100. And note that this is for the season that you're currently on. The seasons will reset over time once the game is actually launched. Something else to note is that this gear that's current in the preseason, it may or may not be present in the next season. So it's one of those things that kind of keeps you probably coming back season after season so you can win some of that rare specialized gear. And in the future, there might be specialized things that you can win on these trees. Maybe they'll add additional breakers, maybe they'll add additional skins, things of that nature. So I can see this game expanding after launch, and you can win some pretty cool things over the different seasons that you're going to play. Next, we're going to talk about the relic system. So as an example, I'm in one of the breakers, and as you can see on the left-hand side of the screen, we have two different relics equipped on this breaker. Now, what happens is when you first start playing a breaker, you have access to only one relic slot. And as you start playing through the planets, you're going to win these different relics that I'm showing on the screen. Each one has a slightly different special ability and a slightly different rarity associated with it based upon the color of that relic. What you can do is you can select one of these relics to put into your slots on your breaker, and you're going to start the game every time you play with that character with those relics equipped. What's awesome is that as you progress through the different galaxies, you're going to unlock additional slots on that breaker. So as an example, for this breaker, I have finished the first galaxy, and that allows me to move on from one relic to two. So in this screen right here, I can have two equipped. Once I win the next galaxy, that'll allow me to equip a third, and then finally a fourth relic. So you can use this to really customize and make your breakers a lot more powerful as you progress through the game. So it kind of pushes you to go on to the harder missions. It pushes you to really challenge yourself, which is, I think, a really cool and great option. Each breaker will start the game with four basic skills. This is a pretty cool system, and it's really how you can customize your character over the course of the game. Every single mission that you go to, at the beginning of the mission, there is going to be a skill upgrade sort of obelisk looking structure at the beginning of the mission. Sometimes you get attacked by monsters and you have to fend them off before you can gain access to it. Other times you can just go ahead and power up your character. Those are typically on the boss missions. So on the screen you can see that this breaker is equipped with four different skills. I do want to make note of the one sort of at the bottom. So each breaker is equipped with a defensive skill. So typically it's some sort of dodge or teleport skill for the lighter characters. And then as you sort of progress onto the heavier style characters, like I'll go ahead and open up Mountain and then look at his skills. So what you can see down here at the bottom is that his defensive skill is going to be a shield type skill, in which you can hold down the button. And what happens is that you're going to block the attacks, and then you're going to regain hit points while you're doing that. So just understand that every single character in this game has a defensive skill. Something else that I want to note is that if you play a lot of video games, one of the things that I did is get a, you know, PlayStation style controller for my computer. And a lot of the games that I play have a defensive button. What I recommend that you do if you're using a controller is just remap the button to whatever games you're typically used to playing. Maybe you're, you know, a Mortal Kombat player and you use the block quite a bit. Go ahead and just set the controller up so that the block is the same or your defensive ability is the same. It'll make it really natural for you to defend and dodge in this game. Next up for the breakers is the weapon. Each and every breaker will start with a default weapon. As an example, this character, Elsa, is going to start with the homing handgun. Now, what's great about it is that when you're starting the character, you know which weapon you are going to be equipped with. Now, over the course of the game, each character will have access to a multitude of weapons, but it is specific to that character. So, Elsa is a gunslinging style character. She will not have access to melee weapons over the course of the game. And, kind of correspondingly, the Mountain is a melee style character. It's going to start with this massive meteor hammer, and they will have access to primarily close range weapons. or heavy weapons, so it could be a host of different things, such as flamethrowers or whatnot. But your character will not have access to all of the weapons in the game, but it will have access to a preset number of weapons in the game. Next up, we have the Toy Worker System. These are upgrades for your account that are fairly pricey, with the breakers being about 1,000 Kron. These come in at 2,000 Kron. But what's great about them, you can equip them on any of your breakers. This is, once again, for your account. It'll give you some sort of bonus. So as an example, the Gunhound is going to increase the weapon power by 10%. I haven't had a chance to unlock any of these yet, just due to the price. I was more kind of focused on trying out a lot more of the breakers. Currently, I'm going to save up and check these out. But it's another part of the game that's fantastic. Another way to further customize your playstyle and customize your account. Next up, I'm going to walk you through how the different galaxies work. So once you have picked a breaker, go to the top of the screen and hit the operate button. So what you're seeing are the three different galaxies that are present in the game. The Cesarini galaxy, I don't even know how to pronounce that. This is going to be the basic galaxy that you go through. And when you click on it, it's going to allow you to basically do five planets total. And you can have a maximum of two players. Now the game doesn't really scale when you add more characters into it, so if you add a friend into the mix, it's going to really decrease the difficulty of the game, which is fantastic. Now, you can't move on to the second galaxy until you've cleared the first one, and this one's going to contain seven planets total and a max of three players. And then the final galaxy, which is going to be the hardest, you have to unlock the middle galaxy before you can go to it, and this one's going to have even more missions that you need to run through. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to unlock it yet because I haven't won the middle galaxy yet, but that adds the highest level of difficulty, and this will allow you to play with up to four players at the same time, which is really exciting. So definitely try out the multiplayer aspect of the game. The single player is fantastic, the multiplayer is fantastic, and this is how the galaxy system works for the game. Hopefully at this point you've learned the basics of Anvil, and you know, the whole point of this was to talk you through some of the basics of the game, so once you dive into it, you have a core understanding of how the different systems work. It's an extremely fast-paced and amazing game. What I'll be doing in the future is kind of publishing some of the runs that I'm going to be doing, so I'll use a different breaker, and then I'll kind of walk you through the game mechanics itself in-game. So a lot of the concepts that I just went over, I'm going to do a mission after this and show you what it looks like in-game and some of the combat, which is absolutely fantastic. It's absolutely exciting, very, very polished, very, very fast-paced. A great, great game. All around, I can't tell you how polished it is, even though it hasn't been released. I've pre-tested and play-tested so many games over the years. This is so polished, it's so slick, it's amazing. The other thing, too, is I have not had it crash one single time during playing, and that is amazing for a pre-release game. So absolutely fantastic, and my thumbs up to the game designers for this. Extremely polished, extremely stable, and a fun, fast-paced game.